Well, joining us right now is our brand new Dundee Stars signing in this interview. It's Gabriel Desjardins. And I'm going to just double check before we start and go any further for our fans, for the announcer, for everyone, exactly how you say your surname.
The English way would be Gabriel Desjardins. So it's pretty simple, I guess, but a lot of people's got a hard time to pronounce it right because there's a couple ways you can do it, but it's the right way, Desjardins.
That, see, now we've clarified that, there'll be no mistakes all year. Everyone can come back here. Just double check that. And in terms of, you know, if fans are to get to know you around the rink, what do they refer to you as? Is it Gabriel, Gabby, Gab? What's the?
Usually my teammate and they call me Desi. Just Desi. It's that's what they call me, or Gabe, or yeah, that's pretty much it.
There we go. Well, we'll go with Desi then, and we can continue that for the rest of the interview. And if there's anything that you don't understand because of accents or anything, just ask again. It's fine.
All right, perfect. I'll do it. Thank you.
I normally start by asking the player, well, how excited are you to be in the Elite League this year and with the Dundee Stars?
I'm really excited, really excited. I heard only good thing about the Dundee Stars and the UK League. My agent talked to me a lot about it. Omar, I had a really good conversation with them. Express how the league is, you know, really physical. It looks pretty much like the North American side, the hockey, and you know, it suits me really well. So I'm really excited about it.
Yeah, of course, your agent is Nick Riopel, which fans know, not for just his time here as our netminder, but for all the players that he's brought to the Dundee Stars over the years to play in the league. Are you feeling a little bit of pressure now on you, being the latest one?
No, you know, it's only fun, you know what I mean? You know, Nick is doing a really good job. And he's bringing, I heard he's been bringing a lot of good player over here. So, you know, I think it's good for me. You know, it's low pressure, but I like it. And from other player that came here before me, from Nick, they told me really good stuff about the city and stuff. So, yes, I'm looking forward. I'm not nervous at all. It's going to be fun.
In terms of the move itself, of course, you mentioned there that you talked to Omar about it, and that obviously convinced you it was the place to be. But how did the move come about in the first place?
We had a good talk for a good 2 hour, me and Omar, and we talked about my past. You know, I had some difficult injury in the past couple years. My first 3 year in Europe, it's been really difficult. So been talking about that and, you know, the kind of player that I was before my bad injury that I got, that we need to get back to that level of, stuff. And, you know, he just told me that he was going to give me, you know, my chance. And I think with Omar that I was going to get the right fit and everything. And like I said, it really looked good. And I just came that way for sure. Yeah.
And to ask you as well, you mentioned it there, of course, you've had your troubles and you're looking to overcome them now. But looking at your CV, you're a player with a lot of experience. You've had a good couple of years in the East Coast League. You've played AHL. You've been all over Europe. How much do you think you've progressed over the years as a player? We'll start off with actually how important were the years playing in the AHL and the East Coast League in America?
Oh, it was a really good good experience. You know, you play with really good player that they got big CV and they got NHL game, and they trying to show you the way. You know, and I was at that time I was younger. I was learning so much, and it gave me really good tool to for the future. For sure.
And then you've had that time in Sweden as well. One of our main broadcast commentators says there's no bad player in Sweden. That's why they all tell when they come here. Just what was that experience like?
It was a really great experience. It was a really bad timing because the year before we had to run the playoff run with my team, and I had a bad injury. I kind of struggled all summer with it, and I came during the year kind of, you know, not 100%, and I grabbed it during the season in Sweden, and it didn't end really well. But I wish, you know, it's the league itself, it's really good. It's a really good league for sure.
And then you made a move to Denmark. You had some time there as well. What was that like?
Oh, it was really good, really great experience. We lost in final too, so it was a really good run. We had a really good team, really nice city, nice little spot, good setup. But we end up losing in final though. But it was a fun time for sure.
And then the 2021 season in Bordeaux.
Yes.
Getting around.
getting around. Yeah, I did pretty much everything, you know. Went to China and Russia and Bordeaux. So it's been a while, that's for sure. But, you know what? Me and my wife and now my new little girl, we're loving it, you know. I think it's fun. So obviously you want to try to find a spot where you can stay for a couple of years, you know, and trying to get it done with the team that you have, hopefully to win a championship, you know. But for me, it's, as you can see, I've been like a little bit of difficulty with the injury, trying to find my gray a bit the past couple of years, but I'm not too worried. That's for sure. You know, I'm ready for a big year.
And what have your friends said to you? Of course, Nick's given you a lot of insight into the league, into the UK league. But what's your perception, or what do you know about it from your friends and from other players that you know?
From what I heard, it's, like I said a little bit early in the interview, it's really physical, skates well, you know, their players are really good. So, and you can have, it's three liners and forward. So I think there's going to be intense and really good games, is for sure.
And what can the fans expect from you this season in that Stars jersey? What if you were to go to the fans right now and tell them exactly what they're going to get, what would you say?
They'll just get a guy that works his butt off. You know, I go on the, every time I'm on the ice, it's 100%. It's no 80 or 70%. You know, I'm going to go out, all out, give everything for the team, and hopefully get it done.
Well, listen, thank you very much for joining us on this interview. Really appreciate it, and we cannot wait to have you here come the start of the season in a few short weeks now.
Moving fast. All right, well, thank you very much. I'm really excited and to meet all the fan and all the team and my team, for sure.
We're excited to meet you as well. Thanks, buddy.
Thank you.